out and 4G rollout in pipeline, there will be surely a huge demand for telecom equipment. As per TRAI estimates, the combined demand is likely to be 264 billion rupees by 2020. So the big question is NTP 2011 likely to provide a roadmap for India to become a leader in cutting-edge state-of-the-art technologies through R&D and creation and incorporation of Indian intellectual property into global standards? This is a big question, not only in the telecom sector, but in many others. We will focus on the telecom sector. And the telecom leaders who are present with us today, through the various panel discussions, provide us insight about how India can achieve this leadership position. There are challenges such as lack of physical infrastructure, small business growth, low productivity, and extensive poverty in rural India. Education, healthcare, and banking need to reach the millions of this country. While the internet provided a big boost to the urban India, it is the mobile which is bridging the digital divide and making it a perfect medium for reaching across the vast expanses of this country and its population. Delivery of services and content to the common man through mobile VAS and broadband is the need of the hour and is the perfect medium too. So can NTP 2011 help us create an ecosystem for participants in the VAS industry value chain and make India a global hub for VAS? To discuss this and more, we have three sessions today. The first one, NTP 2011 Vision, Challenges and Opportunities. The second one, Made in India, the next telecom manufacturing hub, and rural inclusion and telecom. I'm sure the conference is going to stimulate all of us and give plenty of new ideas and insights into what's going on and what will be going on. So with these words, I thank you once again for coming here and welcome you all to the conference and invite the next event. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, that was Mr. Sridhar Shukla, convener, CII Pune IT in Manufacturing Panel and Managing Director, GS Labs Limited. And now I request Professor Dr. Vishwanath Karad, Founder, President and Director General, MIT Group of Institutes, Pune, India, for his introductory address. Dr. Karad, please.
The chairman of today's function and also the chairman of the Confederation of Indian Industry, Mr. Shukla, Mr. Joshi, and other dignitaries on the dais, and my very learned friends in the field of telecom management, rather telecom technologies. Let me confess first that I am not an expert in the field of electronics and telecommunication. Fortunately, or whatever it is, I am a professor of mechanical engineering, having a deep passion to understand what is particle physics. This very important conference, which has been taken under the leadership of the CII, and thank you, Mr. Milind Pandey, to join hands with these people so that the educational institution like MIT Pune, trying to run this telecom management program, this is possibly a very good example of the industry-institute partnership, industry-institute interaction. These words are not new to us. Friends, I am going to make some comments. What I feel on the background of the present development of the whole world, and especially in the field of you call 2G, 3G, and now 4G world over, but how it applies to and what way we look as an Indian. I personally come from a very small village, and whenever I discuss these issues with people, experts like you, the very talented class, intelligent people, I am trying to make some comments on the issues which has been really speaking here. It is a word written, knowledge partner. I do not know whether it is only information and data collection, and thereafter trying to reach the knowledge partner or knowledge device. But more than that, there is a part which is called as a wisdom part of it, of life. And when we look to the wisdom part of it, like the executives, managers and leaders, there is a word which is called as a statesman. I have been always trying to at least understand for myself. I'm not here to advise you or preach you anything, and certainly not to teach, because this is your area. But good luck, Milind Pandey, that you have the student community sitting at the backside, and they have been given a best opportunity to interact with these people. Learn from the very learned, scholarly, intelligent, capable researchers and innovators. The innovation and research has been the new area where when we talk about. Friends, let me tell you, for the India as a country, where we have a very huge population of 120 crores, and it's a country of great villages, the farmers, peasants, workers, to my mind,